Glutathione, I'm sure you've heard about it, but why is it so important? And more importantly, how can you make sure you're getting the best form of it? In today's video, we're gonna cover 5 reasons why glutathione supplementation is a game changer. Also, real quick guys, before we get started, it would mean the world to me if you hit the like button down below, subscribe only if you enjoy the content, and turn the bell on to stay up to date with new weekly videos. Before we jump into why you need glutathione, let's quickly talk about what it actually is. Glutathione is a powerful antioxidant that's naturally produced by the body. It's made up of 3 amino acids, glutamine, glycine, and cysteine. And it plays a crucial role in protecting your cells from oxidative stress and free radical damage. One of the reasons some people can live up to their hundreds is that they have better glutathione recycling via enzymes like glutathione reductase and glutathione peroxidase. These individuals also tend to have better mitochondrial function, which glutathione supports. Think of it as your body's internal defense system, but here's the catch. As we age, or in times of stress or illness, our glutathione levels can decrease, and that's where supplementation can step in. And there is research that suggests that oral glutathione supplementation can effectively raise blood levels of glutathione, even though it was once thought that the body would break it down before absorption. However, liposomal and sustained release forms of glutathione, like the one by Thorne, which I've left an affiliate link for you below that saves you 10%, have shown promising results in improving glutathione bioavailability. Which is good to hear, because you may have heard that glutathione is often referred to as the master antioxidant because it plays a central role in protecting cells from oxidative stress. But it goes beyond that. It also regenerates other antioxidants like vitamin C and vitamin E, which is why it's often seen as the body's defense coordinator. So 2 big takeaways: master antioxidant and defense coordinator. Studies show that older individuals have significantly lower glutathione levels than younger people, contributing to increased inflammation and reduced cellular repair capabilities. But also, younger individuals have been reporting more stress. And when we are under stress, whether from physical or emotional sources, our body produces more free radicals and reactive molecules. This process, what it does, is it depletes your glutathione levels, as it is used to help to neutralize these damaging compounds. It's good to get an initial reading on your glutathione levels first to really gauge where you're at. For example, the whole blood glutathione test measures both the reduced and oxidized forms, giving a comprehensive view of your body's antioxidant status. Some versions also report the GSH2-GSSG ratio, which reflects your body's oxidative stress levels, unlike the plasma-only test, which may not show everything. You need to know where you stand. The first major reason glutathione supplementation can be beneficial is because it assists in detoxification. It plays one of the biggest roles in neutralizing harmful toxins and waste products. It's essential for your liver function, which is your body's natural detox organ, remember? Glutathione binds to toxins, making them easier for your body to eliminate through your urine and sweat. So if you're dealing with things like environmental toxins, pollution, or even dietary stressors like processed foods or alcohol, your glutathione levels could be dropping fast. So the theory is, by supplementing with glutathione, it helps keep your liver working efficiently and your body feeling lighter and cleaner. Moving on to reason number 2, immune system support. Did you know that glutathione is absolutely critical for maintaining a strong immune system? It boosts immune cells like your NK cells, which fight off harmful invaders. In fact, low glutathione levels are linked to immune system dysfunction and increased susceptibility to infections. This pilot study did a great job at highlighting that, showing us that GSH levels were elevated after 1 week with maximum increases of 40% in whole blood, 25% in erythrocytes, 28% in plasma, and 100% in peripheral blood mononuclear cells occurring after 2 weeks. And NK cell cytotoxicity, which was elevated by up to 400% by 2 weeks, which is insane. The third major reason is for skin brightening. Now, some people report this and some don't, so take that with a grain of salt. While it may inhibit melanin production indirectly by interfering with the enzyme tyrosinase, this is not its primary function, and the effect is mild and variable at best. But again, anecdotally, some people do notice that their under eye darkness improves with it. This is because glutathione suppresses tyrosinase, leading to less melanin production and a shift from eumelanin, which is that darker brown black black pigment to pheomelanin, which is that lighter yellow red pigment. This can explain why IV gluta drips temporarily lighten the skin. The fourth major reason is cognitive function and brain health. Glutathione isn't just about detox and glowing skin. It also plays a critical role in protecting your brain. And I think this is one of the most fascinating avenues. The brain makes up only 2% of your body weight, but it consumes 20 to 25% of your total oxygen. Why is that? Because neurons are constantly firing, maintaining electrical gradients, and managing neurotransmitter activity, all of which require intense metabolic activity. This oxygen is used in the mitochondria of brain cells to generate ATP through oxidative phosphorylation. But guess what? During energy production in mitochondria, a small percentage of oxygen leaks out and forms reactive oxygen species, aka free radicals. But so what? It happens everywhere in the body. Yes, to an extent, but in the brain, this can be a problem because the brain is rich in lipids, right? Especially polyunsaturated fats, which are highly prone to oxidative damage. Oxidative stress in the brain is one of the leading factors in neurodegenerative diseases like Alzheimer's and Parkinson's. That's where glutathione steps in. It helps reduce this oxidative damage, supporting neuroprotection and cognitive function. This is why some people combine their glutathione with sulforaphane from broccoli extracts, like the one by Thorne, which one of their capsules is roughly equal to 2 pounds of cruciferous vegetables, which is super cool. This clinical pilot study was able to point us to how the administration of sulforaphane to human subjects could augment blood and brain GSH levels, and that peripheral blood GSH levels may reflect the oxidative stress and redox associated physiology and pathophysiology in the brain, which is really fascinating. And lastly, I think one of the most primarily used reasons why people take glutathione is for athletic performance. Due to intense training and oxidative stress, some athletes just have higher demands for recovery and cellular protection. This is where glutathione can step in, especially the NSF certified for sport version by Thorne, since it's the sustained release formula, which delivers glutathione steadily over time for consistent antioxidant support. But I'm more curious to hear from you guys though. Have you tried glutathione before? Let me know your thoughts with it down below. In the meantime, guys, check out this video on curcumin. And until then, I'll see you on the next one.